Hey everyone, welcome to my guide on how to get RetroArch amongst other apps on Xbox Retail Mode. This applies to Xbox One and Xbox Series consoles. Before I begin, I strongly urge you to join the Discord in the description below, if you're stuck or need a hand. Please don't use the comment section of this video as a support forum. Throughout this video, I will answer some basic questions as we follow along each step, and I'll explain why something is necessary or give quick troubleshooting steps. The end of this video will contain a troubleshooting section with answers to most things we know this far. The description will be kept updated as more information comes out, and you will also find a timetable for each section. Getting whitelisted is very easy. Simply go to the Google Forms link in the description and type in your Xbox Live sign-in email or any email aliases you have on your account. An email alias is a secondary email tied to your account that you can sign in with. If you do not have one, please leave the second field empty. The whitelist is necessary due to how Microsoft's Partner Center works. It won't accept anything other than Xbox Live emails. By joining the Discord in the description below, you'll be able to find out when apps have been updated as well as when you've been whitelisted. It's worthy to note that every time a whitelist announcement is made, everyone who has applied up until that point has been added to the list. To download the apps, you must first open up Microsoft Edge and go to gamer13.github.io. You can only do this after the whitelist announcement. On the website, you'll find written guides, as well as in the Start Here channel on the Discord server. Once you've waited for the whitelist announcement, you can go ahead and click Download App. You'll be brought straight to the Microsoft Store, and you can then install any of my apps. When inside DurangoFTP, leave everything as is. Note the third address highlighted and press the Start button on the bottom. In WinSCP, you must first set it to FTP. Type in the third address down in DurangoFTP into hostname in WinSCP and tick the anonymous box. When you click login, you'll see the following screen. The left side is your PC and the right side is your Xbox. Download the config in the description below and copy it to your desktop. In WinSCP, go to your desktop. On the Xbox side, go to local folder and look for the RetroArch folder name in the description of the Xbox side. The reason for this is that the name is constantly changing and it will not always be the same as in this video. Open the config folder and the local state folder inside that. On the Xbox side, open the RetroArch name folder and the local state inside of that. Next, on the config side, highlight all of the folders and files inside and drag it to the Xbox exactly as shown. If you drag the files over to a folder on the Xbox side, it'll copy into that folder, which we do not want.